In life, we're looking at how do I make a life worth living and retirement worth having. What's always amazing to me is how the players in the streets seem to know a lot more about our cell phones than other people like you and me. The scary part about that is that they often are the ones that are soliciting at cars, sitting on the sidewalk, and literally playing on their cell phones while they're waiting for your pocket coin. The difficulty for you is that you don't know who they are in truth. The sadness for them is that they are likely to get caught by the FBI. And when they're caught, they're caught. Once it's done, it's done. But when these little shits get onto our cell phones, get onto our computers, and think they're literally lord of our lives, they literally get costed. You see, Jesus Christ is not in people anymore. It's probably one of the reasons that I'm no longer Christian, and I become totally pagan. I follow the ways of old, the ways of Odin, the ways of archangels, the ways of angels, the ways of jinn, if you like that particular work. But what I'm talking about is not an alcoholic beverage, just saying. But if you don't know those words, that's on your life. What I'm talking about is having the Holy Ghost give me information. And when I do that, I'm really honoring just about the entire New Testament and a good percentage of the Quran, and at some point I'll be able to read other things. It also helps me because I'm a Confucianist. I also love Mencius, and I don't care if you know who those men are or not. But what I'm talking about is that I've chosen a philosophy of my life. It's kind of along the lines of a doctor, which is do no harm. Do no harm means I don't monkey with you. If you need help and you need solicitation, if you need someone to give you, well, a better vacation, then you can talk to me about your life. That is, you can pay me my consultant fee, and I will give you a reading either from God or from me. I don't have to promise you what the angels say, but if I nail you to the wall, like a black man who rode up on me today trying to play me with some money, I said, no thank you, but I gave him a little reading and he probably thought it was funny. What I'm talking about is that God gives impressions. And I pretty much nailed him, his mom, her possibility of illness and all this sort of stuff to the wall. And it's pretty much been like that for me since I submitted it all. You see, when I lost the most important person of my life, that was at first my late spouse, that was hard for me. But when I lost the best girl I'd ever met in my life, and the two of them that I lost, that almost put me in the floor. And what I mean is that I was not able to walk out the door. You see, in life there are people that change our lives, and the two women that I'm talking about beyond my Buddhist spouse are the two people that changed my life for the Lord. I don't have to explain who they are, I don't have to tell you who they are, I don't have to tell you what the difference are between them. But what I can say to you is that every human being's life, especially a man's life, needs women within their walls. In other words, the walls of their castles. Men build castles. Not in the sand, on solid land. And if you don't have a home like me, then I feel sad for you. But you see, my home was taken because of cybercrime, identity theft, and fraud. Practically committed by people who are supposed to allegedly love me, but more importantly, are supposed to be smart enough about what my father did in his life to be a lieutenant colonel in the military, somewhat like my generalship, but a little different because of how it works and who I'm working for and eventually who will be paying my salary. But what I'm telling you is they chose to be ill. They chose to be ill in their minds and lie to themselves about where their boundaries in life begin and end. They chose to act like lords in my life. They chose to lie about their rights to commandeer property, to sell it, to divide it, to basically use it for bribery. When we talk about these concepts, these are real legal concepts that can end up in federal time. When I'm talking about the theft of my property at jail, that's something that's put on a sheriff, not mine. In life, we have to look at the truth of people. There's always a liar, there's always a cheater, there's always a thief in almost every community. The only question is, who are you today? You might not believe in God, you might not believe in the Holy Ghost, you might not give a shit if you go to hell, because you're such a badass toker. But here's the reality. When people look at you, what do they see? When people look at you, what do they see? I've kind of become sort of accustomed to what people think of me, but I've also known how to literally piss them off, and I sort of enjoy doing that, you see. What I mean is that they like to come up and approach me as if I'm an idiot or a baby. And within a matter of about 5 minutes flat or less, they pretty much quickly understand that they made a huge mistake judging me. In life, we have moments of time to tell the truth. And if you're too busy screwing someone's life, I just want to tell you, go get a fucking life. Your life must be so meaningless to you that you can't walk through the streets focused on you. Please, by all means, focus on your life. Go get yourself a wife, go find some children to mend, and openly get out of other people's lives. The liars of America think they have rights to other human beings' bodies, properties, and paperwork. These are the liars of America that are depleting our society of quality workers, and they're too lazy to work. In life, we have moments of time to decide how we're going to work. I have always been a proponent since my early 20s when I started to study on it, and I read Kiyosaki and other works, that I would rather work smarter than harder. And for most of my life, I did that, and as a result, I produced a very decent living for 3 adult people eventually because my son grew up. And openly, I don't have to explain it to some motherfucking idiot who's never ever actually officially met me by any practical reason. I don't have to explain my life. I don't have to explain my health. I don't have to explain one fucking private thing about me. But I'm putting that to you. You don't have to do that either. But if you're choosing to play low, if you're choosing to harm people, if you're choosing to lie, well, that's on you. And how's it working for you?